Hi guys, welcome back to Charger Lab. After seeing so many chargers for mobile devices, today Charger Lab will tear down something different. It is pretty big, which is the portable electric vehicle charger. The black bag is used to store the charger, and the brand is Bolt. Let's see what's in the bag. There are user manual and charger. The charger adopts glossy black. It's easy to hold, just to put your thumb in here. The top lid can prevent the contacts from damp and dust. The big charging control is oval, and the shell is made of plastic. The brand logo is on the top, and the control button is at the bottom. Then let's take a look at the specs. Model is DA-A16B. Ready input and output voltage are 220 volts AC. Ready current is 13 amp. There's also a screen on the front. Different light color represents different status. The green means turn on, yellow means connected, red means error. So the charging status is clear at a glance. Then let's take it apart. There are two PCBs inside. The left one is fixed by 6 screws and nothing on the back. And there are lots of components on the other PCB. All the communication wires are connected to the joint, such as live, neutral, and ground wires. Disconnect the wire and remove all the screws. The charge spring is on the left. The display is on the right and fixed on a small blue PCB. There are 7 indicator lights in the center and 4 chips next to them. This is the touch sensor IC. And here is the 8-bit shift register with 3-state output register. This is the driver chip used to drive LED lights. And there is another set of same chips. This is the 3.3 volts linear regulator marked with AMS1117. The OLED display is welded on the right. Let's remove it. We can see the flex cables around the back of the PCB. And there is an MCU under the display, which is used to drive the display and comes from Giga Device GD32F130C8T6. This is an 8 MHz crystal oscillator for MCU, and this is a connection slot. Then let's go ahead to remove another PCB. The specs of time delay fuse is 2 amp, 300 volts. There are 3 blue varistors from SCT-SFV14D561K. This is the axial resistor, and this is the transformer used to send the input voltage to the protection chip. This is a Muon Sun power supply, model is LD05-23B12R2. It supports the input of 100-277 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, and the output of 12 volts, 460 mA. It also passed C certification. This is Hongfa Relay, model is HF161F-W. It adopts silver tin oxide contacts and the voltage is 12 volts. This is another. They can control the output of live wire and neutral wire separately. This current transformer comes from Zhenhengtong Electronics ZHT123A, which is used to detect charging current. And the other one is used to detect the zero sequence current and protect the output. Those two small black capacitors come from Lelong, 25 volts, 120 microfarad. Those two small blue capacitors come from Enshi, 35 volts, 47 microfarad, 50 volts, 10 microfarad. This is a step-down converter used to power the chip on the PCB. Model is SG Micro SGM61323A. The specs are 3 amp, 28.5 volts, 1.4 MHz. This is another Giga Device MCU, the same model, but this one is used for charging detection and charging control. This is the single-phase meter from Renergy RN8209D, used to measure the power. It adopts SSOP24L package. This is a gas discharge tube for high-voltage protection, and here is the 814 optocoupler, used to detect the output voltage. This is another 3.3 volts linear regulator, the same model. This is a voltage comparator from ST Microelectronics LM293. This leakage protection chip comes from Fuda Micro FM2147 and can cut off the circuit for safety. This is a 5V TVS protection chip from Chandai Electronics, used for the protection of internal components. Well, that's all components of this portable electric vehicle charger. The smart control module is easy to use and view. It can support IP66 standard and 8 or 10 amp current. You can also set to start charging after 2, 4, 6, 8 hours. It can also provide complete protection, such as overcurrent, overvoltage, and leakage. The building thermistor can detect temperature and the gas discharge tube can prevent lightning strikes. Two microcontrollers are used to control the charging status and drive the display. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you enjoyed this video, please drop a like, leave your comments. We are still exploring different power-related products, so if you want to see more content, please subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!